Good morning. It's great to have you with us here at Unity. Today we're going to journey into the exploration of a spiritual truth deeply behind the Christmas story. As always at Unity, Sunday is that time to touch deeper within yourself, to awaken in a whole new way to the beautiful light and wisdom of your being. Thank you for joining us.
And welcome to Unity of Walnut Creek. Please remain seated and please join us in singing Christmastime is Here.
My name is Sheila Gautreau. I am your assistant minister, and it is my pleasure to welcome you to our service this morning. Hope you had a wonderful time seeing all the little thingies on the grass. I would like you to join me in saying hello to our online friends who are watching from home, the warmth of their home. Hey, we're delighted to have you with us, and we want you to know that your presence adds richly to our service. And also, if this is your first time with us, whether here in the room or online, we'd like to send out a very special welcome and thank you for being here. And if you wish, meet us out on the patio after service so we can greet you personally. We'd like you to know a little bit about us. Unity is a positive path for spiritual living. And what do we mean by that? We mean that we acknowledge a divine presence within each of us, and that that presence is what guides us, and we offer you tools to use every day to apply, and especially on Monday morning when you go to work. We also have a powerful universal focus. You will probably hear as Harmony sings and as we do our sing-alongs with you, different theologies expressed in our music and in our teachings. While we acknowledge and believe that there is only one presence, non-duality, we also acknowledge that there are many paths to that presence. And so we invite you to sit back today and just be open and receptive to what you hear and feel and experience today. Now, we have a spiritual focus each week, and our spiritual focus this week is finding or affirming the light in the midst of the darkness. Affirming the light in the midst of the darkness. And Reverend David will be talking to you more about that in a little bit. Our music today is being led by our wonderful group Harmony and backed up by our house band Fusion. And now Harmony will lead us in our next piece that where you will sing along.
Take that deep breath, let it out, and just let yourself relax deeply in your chair as we turn on that inward journey and begin our entry into prayer and meditation together. And to take that inner journey, I invite you to let the music be part of that guide to the center of your heart. beloved presence of infinite love. Father, Mother, God, guide us to this inner place where our awareness is filled with you. Guide us to this place within our hearts where we know your presence. In that place of inner peace, I invite you to remember the feeling that may have been there on one of those moments when it was still dark night outside, and you watched for the dawn. Remember that place of quiet anticipation with the serenity of night, the quiet of darkness all around. And how even with the eyes open, in that darkness, we cannot see. And yet within, your heart could feel with that joyous anticipation, morning light still to come. And that beautiful wisdom of knowing that at some point, light would begin to fill that world that you were watching. In that part of your heart, in that place where you know the goodness that is unfolding, hold that place for the people in your life that you love. Know that that goodness will be unfolding. That light will come. For those places in your life, whether they are just within or within and without, your heart knows that that illumination of a greater way will break forth. For you are one with that light. And it is within you deep and beautiful understanding and so we know I am one with your light. I am one with all goodness. I am one with the true, deep, beautiful peace of God. And in this place and time of inner peace, let us now enter into silence as the Master guided us. Peace, be still. Mother, Father, God, infinite love, beloved presence, aware of this power, beauty, wisdom that you are in me. I choose to send this forth as love itself. Your love flows through me, and I send it forth to bless and heal and uplift. And I begin by sending this to my own body for healing and well-being. I send it to mind and heart for wisdom and understanding. And I radiate this beautiful love from my heart, sending it to each one dear to me. Healing, blessing, guiding, uplifting, and bringing true peace. I send this love across the spiritual community, becoming a part of that light and wisdom that flows through each person, blessing everyone in their world. I radiate this love, touching every prayer request brought here, knowing with each that they are enfolded in divine love and lifted to that which is the highest. And I send this love from my heart. radiate this love out across these communities in which we live. I send it across this nation, healing its fears and bringing forth its great wisdom and compassion. And I send it across the nations of the world to bring peace. I radiate your love and send it to all who join us in prayer, whether in mosque or synagogue, temple or church, whether gathered at home or on the hillside. For in seeking to know you, we are all one. Beloved Presence, I radiate this divine love from my heart. I send it to this beautiful earth on which we live, to all her creatures. And I send it about the earth to touch the heart of every single person in the earth. For you are that love in every heart. And in that love, we are one. Divine love flows through my heart, enfolding and blessing the world. Please join me. Divine love flows through my heart, enfolding and blessing the world. And again, divine love flows through my heart, enfolding and blessing the world. And once again, divine love flows through my heart, enfolding and blessing the world. So, amen.
Did you hear how the choir? Thank you so much. What a beautiful song, what beautiful voices. Harmony. My name is CL, and it is my pleasure and honor to highlight a few of our upcoming events. Our remembrance service is this Tuesday evening. This is a time to honor those who are no longer able to share the holidays with us on this earthly plane. We are collecting warm clothing and food for the homeless for the next 2 weeks. Details on the clothing being collected are in today's bulletin. This Saturday, we invite Unity members to gather at Unity Center to prepare and serve a gourmet meal for the homeless at a local shelter. Find out more about these and other activities in your bulletin and on our website. I'd like to now invite Sheila to the platform.
Joy to the world, the time has come. Oh, come, all ye faithful, to our choir concert. So come out and get your tickets today. Well, Christmas time is here, so that means the Joyful Noise second annual Christmas concert and Jammin' After Christmas party is taking place next Saturday. Come out on the patio. I've got tickets. Come to the beautifully decorated red table where the Christmas music is playing, and let me sell you lots of tickets for all your friends and family. So we want to see you participate and want to party with you too, okay? Okay?
Great.
Yeah. Okay.
All right.
Thank you, Sheila. Now, until you hear the gong, please take a short moment to greet the people immediately around you.
Is what I'm here to tell. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Wow. So I'm just basking here a moment in there in your music. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Ready or not, Christmas is showing up. The angels came back, and everything is decorated, and thank you for the beautiful Christmas music. And how many have trees up already? Okay, hey, that's a lot of you. Yeah, our tree is up too. And half of it is decorated, and the lower half within 2.5-year-old reach is very creative. It's a wonderful thing, this beautiful experience of Christmas. And there's a part of me that looks at Christmas, looks at that experience and goes, now I know what it's about. I mean, you know, those every Christmas we hear the story and we hear the teachings, but my understanding is that there is also something deeper that it is expressing. Because it's celebrated as a Christian holiday, the birth of Jesus, but the truth is everyone experiences Christmas. And there is a spiritual energy that flows through our time and through our experience, and we're all touched by it. And I believe that's because there is a deeper principle that is being acknowledged, that there is something of greater, even greater power to everyone that's completely universal, that the birth of Jesus and the celebration of Christmas is an acknowledgement of, is a part, is gives expression to. So I was looking to see what that might be. And I remembered that there is a prophecy that talks about the birth of Jesus, or at least the gospel writers, when they look back at the experience of Jesus, they understood and interpreted that this was a prophecy talking about the birth of Jesus. But perhaps it's more than that. Perhaps it's talking about a universal experience of the divine. This from the prophet Isaiah, 9th chapter. The people walking in darkness have seen a great light. On those living in the land of the shadow of death, a light has dawned. And then it goes and it completes. For to us a child is born, to us a son is given, and he is called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. So we're looking at this Hebrew scripture, and it is saying that in the experience of darkness, of people walking in darkness, there comes the experience of great light. And I don't think that's an event. I think that's a truth. That is the very nature of our journey with the divine, because the divine itself is everywhere present. So in those experiences that we would call darkness, what we find is great light. And I think one of the things that caused me to look at this a little bit is, many of you may be aware of the focus on Nelson Mandela. Wonderful time of honoring this magnificent being. But I got thinking, 27 years in prison, That qualifies for me as darkness. Okay, and out of that, not only came an experience that was freedom for him, but it moved into the experience of freedom for the blacks of South Africa and of a new nation being born. And in that nation, an amazing accomplishment. Reconciliation. Instead of the very natural, justifiable experience of the great pain that that people had suffered, being expressed in anger and violence towards others, which anyone could understand because we all have that within us. Something so different happened that it began to continue a change of consciousness in humankind. The experience of forgiveness, honesty, understanding. Amazing. That's light. That is great light. There's a marvelous teacher that I go to when I'm looking at questions of change. My buddy Lao Tzu and his writings in the Tao Te Ching. And for those who are interested in that, this is from the Stephen Mitchell translation. So right at the beginning of the Tao, Lao Tzu begins working with darkness. So let me just take you through a journey of some of his thoughts. Mystery and manifestations arise from the same source. The source is called darkness. Darkness within darkness, the gateway to all understanding. Can you cleanse your inner vision until you see nothing but light? Can you step back from your own mind and thus understand all? The master observes the world. He trusts his inner vision. His heart is open as the sky. Now, what I find with Lao Tzu is great inspiration and great confusion. So, just in case it takes you a little while to think on it, as it does me, let me just read you, kind of guide you back to how I understand what Lao Tzu is talking about there. Mystery and manifestations arrive from the same source. The source is called darkness. Now, to Lao Tzu, darkness isn't bad, it isn't evil, it is simply a part of the experience of the divine. And this darkness within darkness, the gateway to all understanding. So what comes out of this experience of the divine is understanding. Now, the darkness is ignorance. Okay, the darkness is that when we experience personally or however we experience it is where there is not yet an illumination of the true self. Okay, there's not yet an understanding of this divine presence. And so the darkness is its potential, not yet filled with intelligence, not yet illuminated. When I think of Nelson Mandela, the very primitive, fearful parts of ourselves that cause us to control and oppress others, the unilluminated parts of ourselves being expressed in that world. And out of that is a potential to bring a higher consciousness that frees, that empowers, that heals. Darkness within darkness, the gateway to all understanding. But then he gives us this process that he asks us to go through. He says, can you cleanse your inner vision until you see nothing but the light? Can you step back from your own mind and thus understand all things? So the light is understanding. Now, the other thing we know about understanding is understanding comes through the heart. Understanding is a spiritual experience. It's the ability to grasp something in its wholeness. And that comes through the heart. So it shows us how to get there. One says, cleanse your inner vision so you can see nothing but the light. Okay, then he said, can you step back from your own mind and thus understand all things? Well, if we look at the Mandela experience, what's the mind? It is that which creates the emotional reactions to the world around us that keep us locked in the struggle with it. The anger, the fear, the hatred that would very naturally be there are the natural products of the mind, the head, and the way that it processes information. He's saying, can you let go of that to where you see nothing but the light, where you understand all things? Okay, and light and understanding are the same. That's that experience of divine intelligence moving through and illuminating that world. And then he shows us what that looks like. The master observes the world. So we see the world around us. We see what's happening. Not denial. Awareness. The master observes the world, but trusts his inner vision. So it's this heart understanding in which we place our trust. Trust his inner vision. His heart is open as the sky. Beautiful place to get to. Trusting that inner vision, that beautiful understanding, that illumination, that spiritual light and wisdom within you. Trusting the inner vision. Your heart is open as the sky. Beautiful state to dwell in. I trust my inner vision. My heart is open as the sky. Join me. I trust my inner vision. My heart is open as the sky. Again, I trust my inner vision. My heart is open as the sky. There's an interview that I got to see. The interview is of Bill Clinton, and he was being asked about his relationship with Nelson Mandela. And apparently the two were close and had quite a deep connection. And he tells about the experience in which he was at the point where the Republicans in Congress were attacking him and so he was feeling quite put upon, and he has a connection with Mandela. Mandela's there, and they get a chance to visit. So he says to Nelson Mandela, you know, I appreciated so much that you're being able to have your jailer there when the world celebrated your becoming president. And you know, I appreciated the reconciliation work that you did. But he said, how did you get there? Yeah, that's the question. How did you get there? And what he then reports Mandela said to him, says that Mandela said he remembers it very specifically. That it was a realization. He realized that they had taken everything they could from him. And it goes through the emotional abuse and torture and physical abuse and the loss of his family and of his marriage and his career and potential all taken from him, including, he says, his life, what could be taken at any moment. They'd taken everything they could except my mind and my heart. Those I would have to give away, and I would not give them away. That's his realization. They could not take his mind and heart unless he gave them away. And he would not give them away. Then he turned to Clinton and said, and neither should you. The way I understand that is that he would have given them away if he would have given in to simply the natural result that happens. He'd have given in to the hurt and the anger. He would have given them the power to make him like them. But he didn't. He had a different inner vision. He was able to step back from that which the mind creates. We let go of your mind, that you may understand it all. That go and went into his heart and chose to love. That choice was his. That power was his. That choice was choosing a great light in the dark. It is always there, no matter what our darkness. You know, we have our own. You know, it may be around physical health, or it may be someone dear to us that's struggling, and we're in our anxiety and worry about them. It may be something going on in our life, financially, relationships, or it may be entirely internal. It may just be our lack of peace, or the presence of hopelessness, or the many, many things that we journey through that are our darkness. In the darkness is great light. Darkness within darkness, the gateway to all understanding. But it takes that letting go of that way of the mind and moving into the heart. There is the understanding. There in the heart, till you see nothing but the light, you experience the love and the wisdom that you really are. Then trusting that, knowing that is your truth, and your heart becomes as open as the sky. I trust my inner vision. My heart is open as the sky. Join me. I trust my inner vision. My heart is open as the sky. Again, I trust my inner vision. My heart is open as the sky. Your inner vision sees the light. It is filled with wisdom. It is creative power and beauty. Again, I trust my inner vision. My heart is open as the sky. So I invite you this week. We'll probably have a whole lot of good Mandela stories coming up to stimulate us on TV for a while, and that's always a help. And there's the beautiful things of Christmas that invite us into that feeling world. But it also lets us look at places that are still dark within us. Choose your heart. Choose that love and understanding. You can see it. You know it because you are it. It is there that takes us in that choice of the open heart. Takes us into that experience of light. In that darkness of Jesus' time, oppression by the Romans, sleep within spiritual world and leadership, comes a teacher that teaches love and forgiveness. In South Africa, oppression, imprisonment, out of which comes the choice for love and forgiveness. Out of darkness comes great light. You are that light. Bless you.
I can say is wow. That was awesome. If you would like prayer support for challenges or for celebrations, please ask our heart ministers. They will be available after the service here in the sanctuary and out on the patio. Our heart ministers are wearing the lavender stoles. Now I'd like to ask everyone to please take the connection cards in the back of the seat pocket in front of you. And we invite each of you to take a moment to fill out this card. If you have a prayer request, question, or comment, please add that as well. If you are new to Unity, we invite you to fill out the card or stop by the welcome table on the patio after the service. And we do look forward to meeting you. If you are committing to join us in our weekly spiritual focus, let us know that too. Our spiritual focus this week is having an open heart. The ushers will receive your card with the offering toward the end of the music. And now it is time for our prosperity celebration. For credit card donations or love in action, there are envelopes provided in the back of each chair. One of the great teachings of abundance is the Jesus teaching. Give, and it shall be given to you. A good measure pressed down, shaken together, and running over will be poured into your lap. We celebrate that outpouring of divine love in each of our lives. I invite you now to take your tithe or offering in your hand, and be aware that God is the source of all your good. And let's repeat our affirmation together. Divine love through me blesses and multiplies all that I am, all that I have, all that I give, and all that I receive.
Our children are busy getting ready for the Christmas family service, so they aren't going to be joining us. So let's send our blessing to our children and also to that child within each of us together. Children, you are loved, special, and important. The light of God shines through you. I invite everybody to stand and take hands, and let's share together our prayer protection. Together, the light of God surrounds us. The love of God enfolds us. The power of God protects us. And the presence of God watches over us. Wherever we are, God is, and all is well. And our peace song.
And
are the love and the light and the peace in the earth right now. So let it shine and have fun.